So I'm leaving the challenge to you. I want to challenge you to make your dreams come true as well. And you can. Say to yourself, I'm going to make it happen. Look around you every day to see what can be done better. For example, why do diabetics stick their fingers every day and it hurts so bad? That's barbaric. Why don't somebody figure out a way to eliminate that? There are hundreds of things that can be done simply. So put together your network. When you find your idea, never give up. You will succeed, you'll make it happen, and you will make a difference. So I'd like to close with our trip to Haiti. For me, this has been a highlight of my tenure with VitaCare. As you probably know, Haiti is one of the poorest countries in the world. It's just unbelievable. And what happened 3 years ago, the earthquake killed 315,000 people, and it was devastated. A year later, a hurricane came by and it stirred up a cholera epidemic that they haven't ever had there. And the cholera epidemic was killing people right and left. And as was mentioned earlier, they don't die from the infection, they die from dehydration. They can lose 3 gallons of water a day. And so the EZ-IO was an absolute life-giving device for them. My mission then, when I heard about this, my mission was to go to Haiti and take the devices down there. I got this picture in the mail, in the email. And you say, what is it? Well, it's a DeWalt drill, it's a jackknife. The letter was sent to Harvard University, and then it was sent to me. It was from Dr. Mark Welch at Albert Schweitzer Hospital in Haiti. And the letter said some nasty things, but it said, first of all, he's losing a lot of patients because he can't start IVs. And he knew about the EZ-IO, but he couldn't get one down there, so he said, I'll make my own. He used a knife, he cut into the bone, he used a DeWalt drill, and he was able to get a needle into 2 patients to save their lives. He lost the life of a 19-year-old pregnant mother. So he sent the letter, and he said, the answer is simple. Get a hold of the company and tell them to send some EZ-IOs down here immediately. No excuses and no bullpens. And I saw that letter, and I said, wow, he's right. I went to Mark, and I said, I'm going to Haiti. How many needles can we get? And Mark said, you know what? It is the right thing to do. We're going to scrape together every needle we can find around the country and in our warehouse and from our manufacturer. We pulled together 1,200 needles. I said, we're going to pack them and get down to Haiti as soon as we can. So my mission was not to go down and treat patients, obviously. I was to go down to all of the cholera treatment centers. There are 23 of them in the country. And I was to train the doctors on how to use this and the nurses how to use it, give them a supply of EZ-IOs, and let them save the people's lives. Here I am talking to Doctors Without Borders, and I was able to do that. So the other thing, while I was there, I did get to save the life of a little girl, and I'll show you in the video shortly. So the interesting thing before I went is you can't just appear in Port-au-Prince with a bag full of needles. So here I am, right? What are you going to eat? What are you going to drink? And, you know, you can't do that. So what I did is I went on Facebook, and I said, I'm going to Haiti. I need food, water, housing, translation, transportation, and so on. And within a couple hours, I got a call from General Timbo, and he said, we have an operation, Project Hope, in Haiti. And so Fred Gerber called me from Haiti, and he said, we'll give you food, a good meal once a day. We'll give you water, housing. We have a transportation for you with a translator. And we already supplied it. The cholera treatment centers with IV fluid, so we know where they all are. We'll take you to all of them, and so you can do that. I said, okay, how are we going to get through customs? The only way, anytime you ship things or take things into Haiti, they confiscate them for months. The only way you can get through customs is if you go in as a rich tourist. So I said, I need a private jet. And I also, that morning, asked for a private jet on Facebook. And by 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I got a call from this gentleman. He said, come to the airport. Have you got your jet yet? And I said, no. He said, come and look at my jet. So I went to the airport. I said, this is a beautiful jet. I said, how much is it going to cost me? He said, not a penny. I want to do this for the people of Haiti. So I had my jet. I said, okay, I need somebody to carry these things for me and take some videos. So I confiscated and kidnapped my brother-in-law, Paul. But can you see how this coming together? This was really the providence of God, I think, that came together to make all this happen. So I'm going to share this little video with you. It's a very short one. If you want to see a longer one, you can see it on YouTube. gives you an impression of what you can do in a country like Haiti with a device like EZIO, a little bit about Haiti, and maybe this will give you some encouragement to take your ideas from here. So without further ado, I'll give you a little video that we took and a few comments along the way. Here we are loading them in suitcases as a rich tourist, right? Loading them on the jet. So we get through customs, so we made it through customs. 3.5 hour trip to Port-au-Prince. And this is typical around the country of which you'll see. It's faster to walk than it is to drive. The cholera treatment center in Maloa, Haiti, up the northern part of Haiti, devastated by the cholera.
Without any parents. I need some.
So I leave you with this video and hope this will inspire you. I thank you again so much for this award. It means the world to me. It is a dream come true. And God bless you all. Thank you.